Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This is Java Foundations for naive high school students. As of now we are talking about basic programming. We have spoken about primitive data types and variables, methods or functions, and then we have seen string a bit in detail, then decision statements, and then also we have seen about operators. Now we will actually talk about loop constructs, which is for and while loop. Okay, so before getting into loop construct, Rishi, you need to understand a few things which are very basic. Okay, those are how to increment and decrement. And the way you can increment, let me take the control. We have already spoken about typical arithmetic operators like plus, minus, multiplication, division, etc. So now we will talk about a special operator called incrementer or decrementer. So incrementer is actually plus plus, which means it will actually add one at a time. If you do minus minus, it will decrement. So for example, in this case, if you say system dot out dot println and I1 plus plus, okay, and you can either postfix or prefix. So this is postfix, and there is a difference in the functionality if you postfix and prefix. Okay, now I will add one more, system dot out dot println plus plus I1. Okay, so this one is postfix, okay, similarly we will also do prefix. Okay, and let me run it and then we'll talk about the differences. So I1 is originally 16. When you declare the variable, you initialize to 16, and then we try to print by postfixing and prefixing. Okay, so this one we have to go up a little bit here. So if you see, even though you say plus plus on I1, the value is still 16, whereas here it became 18. Okay, so the reason is, so that's the difference between postfix and prefix. So first it will return the value and then increment it. So for example, it will make more sense if you create a new variable like int I3 equal to I1 plus plus. I'm commenting it out. So when you do postfix, I1 will be assigned first to I3. So here we have two variables. So you need to understand what two variables means. For that, I am stopping you as presenter, and I am making myself as presenter. And then I will explain the differences, and then I will make you presenter again. Okay, I just have to share the screen. I'm opening the Excel spreadsheet and think this entire stuff as a RAM, okay, and consider each cell as a byte, okay. So when you actually RAM means memory. So whenever you have some application running, it uses certain amount of RAM. In this case also, when you run the Java program, not when you actually develop, but when you run by saying run application, first what it will do is it will create multiple variables. So you started with i1 and i2, okay. So let's say most of the memory is full. And also let me add these two, let me give the borders, and then let us say there are some things which are not full. Okay, so these white sections are available space in memory, and these light blue are filled space in memory. So in this case, you create i1 and i3 as integers. How many bytes it takes? I think it takes 4 bytes, right? We have covered those things earlier. So if the data type is integer, it takes 4 bytes. If it is short int, it will take 2 bytes. If it is byte, it will take 1 byte. If it is float, I think again 4 bytes. If it is decimal, double, it is 4 bytes. So when you create variables such as i1 and i2, it will take 4 bytes of memory, which is consecutive. Okay? So this one will be i1. So when we say i1, it represents, the variable represents the relative byte address of the memory. So whatever address, so from the Excel perspective, this is Y13, right? So from memory perspective, this will have some byte address, okay, starting from 0 in the first byte till here, whatever it will be represented as that. I1 represents a name to that byte address, okay. And then when you actually say 16 in it, each byte is 8 bits, so all the bits will be 0 in this, and then here it will be 0001, so this is 16. Okay, so this is how it will represent. In this case, these 3 bytes will be 0000 in all the bits. Okay, so this will be the 16, and this byte address of these 4 bytes will be i1. Okay, and then we have i2. So let me fill with a different color here. Okay, and I think it is 13 or something, I do not remember exactly. And 13 is 1101. Okay, so I think that is 13. So this represents 13, this represents 16. Okay, so and the name which will be given to this will be i1. So when I say i1, I am representing from here to here, and this one is i2. Now when you increment, saying plus plus, okay, and assign it to a variable i3, so i3 again represents a different 4 bytes, okay, so this will be i3. Okay, so when you say i3 equal to i1 plus plus, whatever is there here will be assigned to I3, and then one minute. Okay, let me change the color here. So whatever, so it will create a new variable with which takes 4 bytes consecutively, and then I1 will be incremented. Okay, so I3 will be 16 and I1 will become 17 after assignment is done. So if you review what we have done, we have given like this int I3 equal to I1 plus plus. Same is the case with system.out.println. So when we say system.out.println and try to read I1 plus plus, first whatever the value is in I1 will be returned. It will be printed, and then I1 will be incremented. So internally, I1 will become 17, but printing it will be 16 only. If it is prefix operator instead of I1 plus plus, if we do plus plus I1, what will happen? First it will increment I1, and then it will copy the results to the new variable, which is a new byte address in the memory. Okay, so that's what is happening with a postfix operator and prefix operator. So with postfix, whatever value that is there in the variable will be first assigned to a new variable, and then the original variable will be incremented. So the new one is I3, the original one is I1. So when I say I3 equal to I1 plus plus, I3 will be 16 and I1 will be 17. Now if I say I4 equal to plus plus I1 is already 17. We are incrementing first, so it will become 18, and then 18 will be assigned to I4. That's what have happened with our system.out.println plus plus I1. So that being said, let me make you the presenter here. I am stopping sharing the screen, and I will make you the presenter. Now you can actually share your screen, and if you have any questions with this incremental operator, let me know. Otherwise we'll move forward. Is it clear?
If I have any questions, we'll see as we go on.
Okay, sure. But you are getting it right. Anyway, we will be seeing while loop and for loop, and we'll be using this operator quite a bit. And if you have any questions in your mind, eventually they will be sorted out. Don't worry if you do not get it completely. So first start visualizing the memory, how the memory will be. And then whatever concepts I have covered earlier, like how the integer will be, what is the size of the integer. And now I have covered how that will be represented in memory. So when we say 4 bytes, your memory will be fragmented. Your memory will be used to hundreds of applications. The way I have shown in the Excel sheet, memory will be fragmented. You will be having holes here and there. And whenever you create variables, it will start using the memory when you run the application. And then whatever I have explained will happen internally to get the results. Even if you cannot relate all these things together, at least make sure you understand by trying out different examples about increment, postfix increment and prefix increment. Same is the case with decrement. And then we should be good to go. Okay. So now let's talk about loops. So the purpose of loops is, if you want to do the same thing repetitively, then you should start using loops. For example, let's say from 1 to 100, I just want to print 1 to 100. There is no point in, let me take the control here. So there is no point in creating 100 variables like this, and then println i1. Okay, let's say i001. So it doesn't make any sense to create variables like this, i001 equal to 1 and print. There should be a better way of dealing with this, and that's where we got loops. There are two types of loops. One is while loop. Okay, and the other one is for loop. So we will see when which loop should be used when. In most of the cases you can use either of them, but there are some specific cases where one will take the precedence over the other. Okay, so when it comes to while loop, first let us understand the syntax. It will be like while a condition which returns true or false. Okay, and then you implement whatever logic you want. Okay, and you need to have so as long as the logic is true, it will get into the while loop. As long as the condition which you have defined in while is true, it will go to the while loop. Otherwise, it will exit. So this is one way of writing the while loop. And typically, when you implement this logic, you need to make sure in such a way that somewhere this the condition which is specified here will return false. Okay, so let us see the example. It will make more sense once we see the example. So let's say from 1 to 100, I just want to print. I don't want to do anything else. So I am creating a variable I. Equal to 1. Okay, and then I can say while I less than or equal to 100. I just want to print ln I. Okay. And then you have to, if you put this condition, what will happen? I will always be 1. So it will, I less than or equal to 100 will always return true. Hence, you will get into the infinite loop. It will keep on printing 1. So somehow you have to make sure that you this condition returns false. In this scenario, how you can achieve? By just incrementing I, like this. Okay, so whether you prefix I or postfix I, it doesn't matter. Okay, because after this statement only, it will actually go to the while loop. So it is, this I plus plus here is same as I equal to I plus 1. So either you can say I equal to I plus 1, or you can say I plus plus, or plus plus I. All are same. Okay. So instead of, so this is one way of incrementing after printing the result. Okay. Instead of writing additional line of code, you can also say I plus plus here. So it will just print I and then it will increment, right? So we have already seen here. So we can actually develop the logic by just saying I++ here, and then it will print 1 and then it will increment. When it goes to the while loop, I will become 2, and 2 less than or equal to 100 will be true, and hence it will get inside. It will print to 2, and then it will increment to 3. Like that, it will actually check the condition. You can actually run this here. Let me first comment these things out so we can see the cleaner output. Okay, one thing is you need to format the code properly. Okay, one way you can do is by right clicking on this, go to source and then format. See, now it is much cleaner. Did you get it, Rishi? Hello?
No, you...
I will show you again. So it used to be like this, which is not formatted properly. Okay, see here. So this is not a very proper way of indentation. You see the main loop, the curly brace, which is closing the higher level block, is indented at multiple levels than the lower level. So this is not proper way of indenting. It is not properly formatted. So one way to achieve this is by right clicking on anywhere in the program. Okay, go to source and click on format.
Okay.
Now it is better. You can also apply certain format rules. By now, as of now, it is indenting 4 space characters each time. If you want to customize, there is a way to do that. But don't worry too much about it at this time. You can actually play with this once you are familiar with Java. Okay, for now just use simple formatting technique so that code is a bit readable for you. So I am commenting this also. Okay, now let us run the program. You see here, it has printed 1 to 100. Out of the options, out of the available options, this is better way of coding, system.out.println i++. You can also do i and then i equal to i+1. Okay, but if you are incrementing only by one value, probably this is a better way of printing the results. But if you want to just get even numbers, you have to add the if condition. And then you have to check whether if I is even or not, and then you have to print only if the condition satisfied within the while loop. Okay, and that is one way of doing it. Another way of doing it is first move to the first integer number, first even number. Once you reach the first even number, you can actually increment I by 2. For example, in this case, if I have to print even numbers, I will write both the logic so that you understand how to visualize the problem statement, understand your requirement and put it in proper manner. Okay, so here let's say this will be passed let's say there will be two parameters which will be passed to you, the minimum number and maximum number. And within those numbers, you have to print the even numbers, okay? So, first what you can do is, the best way of dealing with it is, first you need to say, if I mod 2 equal to 0, okay? Then, let's create two more variables, int lower bound and int upper bound. Okay, so upper bound let us initialize to the value whatever you will be passing as argument. Passing arguments and all we will see later. For now, we will actually see how by the hard coding way, then we will actually create a function for this and we will try to get it done as a function by passing lower bound and upper bound as parameters and then creating a function to print even numbers or odd numbers, whatever it is. So let's say the problem statement is to print the even numbers. Okay, so in this case, if I mod 2 equal to 0, it is a even number. So we can set lower bound to I. Okay, but if I is not even number, what you have to do in the else part? You just have to set the next number will be typically even number, right? If I mod 2 equal to 0, well and good, Sn I to lower bound, that will be the first even number. If it is an odd number, we are just incrementing so that we can get the next even number. Now, while I less than or equal to upper bound, okay, I just want to print I and I equal to I plus 2. Here I have to say LB, lower bound, not I. Making sense?
Yeah.
You can also achieve the same functionality. Let me run it first. Now you got the only even numbers. You can also achieve the same functionality by saying using if condition in the while loop. But that is not the appropriate way of doing it because you are unnecessarily performing more number of operations. In this case, we have performed one operation to set lower bound to an even number within the range, the first even number within the range, and then we are incrementing. So from 1 to 100, we are only looping 50 times, we are not looping 100 times. But if I increment one at a time and if I check if condition as part of the while loop, you are looping 100 times and in each iteration you are actually checking whether if it is an even number or not. So the number of operations you are performing are relatively very high and it is not very efficient way of programming. So when you think about the problem, there will be multiple solutions. You need to come to conclusion with the efficient solution, not the easy solution. Okay, so you have to think multiple options and then you have to determine which one is good among the options you thought through and you have to decide on the best option. And then you should be able to adapt a better solution if someone else proposed a better solution than the options you thought through. That's how you should improve your analytical and programming skills. Okay, so that being said, now let us make it a function. So again, as part of the Eclipse, there is a way to create the function for your program. Okay, so in this case, let us select this part LB, UB equal to 100, etc. And then right click on this, go to refactor, okay, and then click on extract method. And then you can give the method name. The method name is print even numbers. Okay, now you see it will create a function called print even at the top and it is invoking the print even here. I think print even is at the bottom. Let us see where it is generated. Yeah, you can see it here. Okay, but there are few changes which I want to make. I want to take the lower bound and upper bound as the variable name, as the argument names, that that make more sense. Okay, and then here, if lb mod 2 equal to 0, then I just want to, actually what I can do is, if lb mod 2 not equal to 0, which means if it is odd number, I just want to say lb plus plus. There is no need to create additional variable also. Okay, so we are resetting the argument itself, and then we are looping from this number. If this is false, I can delete this. If lb mod 2 not equal to 0 is false, that means it's even number, we are not changing any value in lb. This is much more concise way of coming up with the solution. And then here it is complaining because we are only passing one parameter. So I will say lb equal to 1 and int ub equal to 100, and then I want to pass lb comma ub. Okay, and then we can run this program and it will get the even numbers. So this is how you can actually write a simple while loop. And there is a variation of while loop also, where we don't increment or decrement, but somehow you need to exit. So if you are incrementing or decrementing at on the same variable on which you are applying the while conditioning the while loop, at some point it will become false and it will exit. But sometimes we will write code like this: while true. Okay, so by default we are actually getting into infinite loop, but based upon certain condition, if condition is false, we want to break from the loop. Okay, and as part of your programming logic, somewhere you this condition will become false as part of your main logic in the while loop, and then you can actually say, you can implement whatever logic you want. So this is a bit extreme example which you don't need to worry at this time, but this is another approach where we actually develop the while loops. Okay, so one is this one and the other one is this one. That being said, I will wrap up this session unless you have any questions. When I say this session, this video, and then I will create a new video for loop. Any questions here about while loop?
No, I get it.
Okay, so I'm stopping this.